And now to an Indian, a family with quite a history. He was the human cannonball, and his wife used to light the fuse.
Yeah, they were a very popular act in the now-defunct Ringling Brothers Circus. But our Kevin Rader discovered their story didn't end there.
The old axiom is the family that plays together stays together. Well, the misers of Miami County are living it, and now they can even live in it.
So when you two look at this car out here, what do you think?
The first time I saw it, that's a little bigger than I was remembering it.
Tina and Brian Miser used to call a railroad car like this home when they performed with the Ringling Brothers Circus. So when the circus stopped, they actually bought one of the train cars and moved it to their rural Miami County home.
This was like the apartments that went down the track, a whole town that went down the track. So it was a whole different lifestyle, a whole different way of being, and so we don't want that to have to end.
Brian was the human cannonball, and he still is.
Two cannons in here, and there's one on its way back from Germany that went over there and did a TV show a couple weeks ago.
And it all started in his in-law's backyard.
He pitched the idea to them, and their talent scouts came here to Peru, Indiana, and watched him get shot out of a cannon on fire in my parents' backyard.
Now they've constructed their own family playground.
So this is our fun. This is what we do for fun. It's our big circus playground.
And 13-year-old daughter Skylar is preparing for a possible career into the big top as well.
What kind of life was that?
It was awesome.
Exciting.
Yes, it was awesome.
Tell me why.
You know, you sit here at the dinette table and you're watching the world go by. Families would be coming out of their homes and waving at you as the train was going down the tracks. It was like, I guess, nothing else.
The seed was sown in Peru, and now it's being passed on in Peru as well. In Miami County, Kevin Rader, Channel 13, Eyewitness News.